Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited that the news is out and you guys know about baby number two. If you haven't seen my announcement and my gender reveal, I'll link it up here for you guys. If you want to find out the gender from the reveal and not from me and you haven't seen it yet, go watch it because I'm about to say it. But I'm so excited that you guys know. Some of you are probably surprised to see the video and that I shared like the announcement and the gender reveal together, but there was no reason to make you guys wait, like when we already knew the gender. I wanted to film an announcement video. I finally got around to it. And then there was no reason to like make you guys wait and do like a reveal weeks later when we already knew. So I just decided to put it all together for you guys. So I hope you liked that. I feel like the reveal was perfect. It turned out so cute. Kenzie and I watched the video probably 100 times a day. I'm not even kidding. We love that video. I want to thank Lowell for sponsoring a portion of today's vlog and being a part of Kenzie's Big Girl Bed Makeover. I'll share more about that later. So we're so excited for baby girl number two. This morning I'm out and about. I'm actually going to go look at some baby things at Target this morning. I wanted to bring you guys along. I haven't gone anywhere in a while, so I have my mom and grandma over with Kenzie right now. They're playing with her and I have like an hour to go do whatever. So I'm going to place a little Starbucks order, get myself a drink, and go to Target and shop around with you guys for a minute. Check out the cute baby girl things, maybe some home decor, clothes, I'm not really sure, but just taking a little bit of time for myself this morning. We had an injury in the house. The other day I shared on Instagram like our Christmas gifts that we got Kenzie. If you guys watched that, and I shared that we got her the stair slide. And of course we were going to wait until Christmas to give it to her. It was a Christmas gift, right? But my husband and I, the other day, it was cold and we were like, you know, we should just give it to her now because then she'll have like the whole month of December to play with it. Why not, right? And I was like, okay, that's fine because she has like all of her small gifts to open on Christmas. She might as well start enjoying her stair slide. Well, we had our friends over the other day, a couple who we've been friends with like forever, like over 10 years. They brought their little girl over. We were all hanging out in the basement and the boys decided to go down the stair slide. So our friend went first. He was in jeans. He did fine. They put it basically like vertical on the stairs and like the whole length of our basement stairs. Like they made it a huge slide. So our friend went first. He was fine in jeans. Then my husband went down. He was wearing like athletic shorts. So he went a lot faster and he broke his tailbone, you guys. Not even bruised it. He actually broke the bone. So my husband has a broken tailbone and we've just all been at home hanging out and stuff. I'm just taking a moment for myself this morning to go out and about. I feel so bad for him. He's in so much pain, you guys know, or hopefully you don't know, but I'm sure that you've probably heard broken tailbones are extremely painful. Yes, I still recommend the stair slide for kids. It's not really an issue when like my 30 something pound toddler goes down a small normal size slide, but it's adjustable and they decided to make it a massive slide. And yeah, so I still recommend it for your kids, just not for your husband. I have a lot of aversions to drinks right now, but you guys know I'm really into like fruity things if you watched my pregnancy recap. So I just placed an order for a dragon drink, a tall dragon drink at Starbucks. I'm about to go through the drive-thru and grab that. It's only 35 milligrams of caffeine, so well within the limit. Okay, I got my dragon drink. I don't know if I called it a pink drink earlier. I can't remember, but anyways, I usually get the dragon drink, so. If you guys have a favorite Starbucks drink that doesn't have coffee in it, let me know. I won't do any coffee ever, so. If you have a fave with no coffee, I usually do a dragon drink. Every now and then I'll do a strawberries and cream frap or a vanilla bean frap with raspberry. Let's go to the ocean. Yeah, let's go outside. We can hang out on the beach without freezing. Yeah, isn't that amazing? In Christmas time. We'll be chilling and having a good, good time. Doesn't matter if the snow is falling or the wind blows and the rain is pouring. It will always be Christmas in my heart. But this year I wanna hang out with my friends and family, making angels in the sanctuary. Doesn't matter, it is Christmas. Can Okay, I'm heading home. Just a small little haul. I'll share it with you guys when I get home. I need to get home and get Kenzie down for a nap, but just a couple baby outfits and some organization things. Okay, quick Target haul for you. I got a couple things for organizing. I have a couple drawers in Kenzie's room that I need to organize, and I love these bins from Target. She already has some of these in her closet, so they'll match, but they're super affordable. They're like $2 a pack, so three of these long skinny ones and then a two pack of these bigger ones. And then, oh, I got a Rachel Parcell calendar. These are so cute. I love Rachel Parcell. And I needed a new January or 2022 calendar. So I love that pattern. I grabbed one of these clear like shoebox size bins for all of Kenzie's dollhouse stuff that's downstairs. She has a ton of like dollhouse furniture and little tiny like food and stuff that goes in her dollhouse. So I want to put it all in a bin. And then two things for baby sis. I love both of them. The first one is by Little Planet Daisy. Scoot over. All right, I'll show you that one next. But I found this little Burt's Bees baby outfit. I got 3 to 6 months. And it was only $5.38. I love the ruffles. So sweet. And then I got this little sleeper, which I love. It's the Little Planet Organic brand. It has the two-way zipper, and I just love this sweet little pattern. Okay, so now I'm going to share how we set up Kenzie's big girl bed. We finally transitioned her from her crib to like the toddler bed, and then we just decided to go to a full-size bed. So she got a Lull mattress. It's the original mattress. I love it. It comes right to your door. As a mom, I really appreciate things that come right to your door that we don't have to drag the family out for. So it's delivered to your house. It's free shipping, free returns. They have a 365-night trial and a lifetime warranty. So setting it up is really easy and convenient. As you can see, we just kind of pulled it out of the box. We remove all of the plastic, drag it over to her bed frame, and cut off the final layer of plastic and then let it expand. And you can sleep on it that same night. You can get $300 off any size original mattress using my link below, and thank you so much, Lull, for partnering with me on today's video. Okay, I wanted to give a little update now that we've had our Lull mattress for a little while and gotten the chance to sleep on it. Kenzie has been sleeping on it for a while now. The night that we got it, we didn't have the Lull foundation yet, so we had like a temporary setup, and then our Lull foundation came a few days later. So we have the complete setup now, and we all love it. Kenzie girl is so happy. And it's so nice having her in a full-size bed. We can all cozy up in here. We love the Lull mattress. I personally think it's the perfect combination of firmness and like soft squishiness. I think this is absolutely perfect. So I'm so happy that my girly is happy and enjoying her big girl bed.
I'm up in the office now. I'm about to fill out a few things on my calendar that I already know the dates for. I love how this has the little brass hook at the top. It's super pretty. It was only $5.99. I'll link it below for you guys. It comes in other sizes as well. If you like a full size like desk calendar, they had that too. But I really like this. So I'm gonna work on that for a minute and then pull out all of the baby clothes. Okay, this is baby sister's room. It used to be my office when we first moved here, and now our office is across the hall. We have like a joint office. But we just had this room painted white. And this wall over here is going to be the crib wall, so I'm thinking about doing some kind of accent wallpaper over there. I have one in mind from Lumwell. Let me know if you guys have tried Lumwell wallpaper, but I just grabbed some clothes to start going through. We have 3 bins and a random loose pile to start going through. And then I need to pull out all of the like gear stuff and organize it better in this closet because it was over in my office closet. And then I have some things in Kenzie's room too. I'm just starting to move over like the Ubi pail and stuff. We don't use that in Kenzie's room anymore. The little rocking chair. Just slowly bringing things out. I had it all organized by size, but I think I'm gonna just do like a bin of pajamas, a bin of summer stuff, a bin of winter stuff. I'm not really sure. The sizing thing is weird for me because I'm assuming this baby is gonna be like Kenzie and be very off in her sizes. Kenzie was a really big baby at 7 months old. She wore 18 months and on her first birthday, she was already in 3T. So sizing is kind of whatever. I feel like I'd rather have it by category. But look at this winter stuff I'm starting to pull out. Oh my goodness, I could cry. It's all so cute.